but just how people would speak about you because you're a woman, you're a hoe, you're a thot, anything. Like, it's just crazy to me. And I find they don't do that to men, but they definitely will do that to a woman. Or they'll be like, oh, you need to get ass shots, you need this. Why do you care? Mm. Like, I'm not fucking you.
Yeah.
So you should not care at all what I look like. I don't care what you look like.
Jay-Z said it the best. You know, what I eat don't make you shit. You know
right.
what I mean?
Like, why do you care?
You know, it's funny because people just want to find info or gossip. You know, they try. And again, this is something we spoke about the last time. And mm-hmm. as we just surf back over, even with, what's his name? It was in my mind. When they try to make this dude, Gucci man. Mm-hmm. When they try to say, like, he tried to say something. Or even people, but you know what? Even Lip Service, your mm-hmm. podcast, right? Which focuses on a lot of sexual stuff, too.
Yeah.
How have you been able, and I mean this, and I think I said this before, you could talk about sex, but you're not out there like that. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, you're not, you could, like, you, I feel like you've been professionally, you know, you've learned how to professionally talk about things that people don't like to talk about.
What? Well, when I first started Lip Service, it was supposed to be an empowering show for women. The reason why I started it was a couple of different things. When I was at Sirius, I found that a lot of these women that were like in music videos that guys were lusting over, nobody even knew what their voices sounded like. Mm. And nobody knew anything about them as a person. So I did that because I wanted to give these women a voice, not just a person that you see in a music video or you see pictures of and you're like, oh my God, I love her. I wanted it to be like, let's see what this woman's personality is like. Let's give her a platform to speak and tell her own story. And the other reason I did it was because there's just women, everyday women, and we just want to talk about different things that we're interested in, but maybe don't have an outlet for that. And it's so taboo. Oh, we're not supposed to be talking about sex. We're not supposed to talk. But then where do you learn how to do certain things?
Sure.
Maybe you want to learn how to give a great blowjob. Well, where can I go to find that out? Maybe you want to learn how to participate in S&M. Well, where can I go to? Let's talk to people who have actually done these things. And if it's something that you want to experiment in, at least now you have information from people who have done it, other points of view. Like, sometimes I think we're hard on ourselves and we think that we do things as women and we even look at ourselves and be like, oh my God, I'm such a hoe, I did this. But then you can hear other women say, well, I've dated more than one guy at a time, or, you know, I went through a period where I was sure. doing whatever, and we shouldn't feel bad about that. So it was just important to me for us to own who it is, what we are sexual beings.